Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals. And with the way the economy's going and the price of gold spiking, I wanted to demonstrate three different pieces of equipment today for you with a sample of gold ore that we got from a customer. And these three pieces of equipment are kind of specially designed for miners who maybe are on a budget or don't have the size of operation that needs our 1 ton per hour turnkey system. And so we're going to start here with this 6x10 jaw crusher run by a gasoline motor. Then we're going to take the sample over to our 16x12 hammer mill and run it down onto our 4x8 shaker table to recover the gold. All right, so now we've got our buckets of material we crushed through the jaw crusher. We've brought them over to our other equipment. This is a 16-inch by 12-inch hammer mill. And with a 0.8 millimeter screen, it's gonna grind our material up to 70% passing a 30 mesh screen and about 50% passing a 50 mesh screen. That will liberate the gold in our ore. We'll run it wet, so a slurry is made that runs down onto our shaker table. And then the gold and the heavy minerals are gonna come across the shaker table under the water bar, where they'll come down into the number one and number two ports. The sulfides are gonna come down into the number three or middlings port, and then the tailings are gonna flow down into the number four port, and those would go to your waste or your tailings pond. And so with these three pieces of equipment, the jaw crusher and then the hammer mill and shaker table, you can take run-of-mine or dump piles, waste piles, and process them and get the gold out easily and by hand.
here, so I've taken our number one and number two off the shaker table, and I'm just going to pan these down real quick, and we'll see. There's kind of the amount of material we had. A little bit of quartz on top, but I'll pan this down, and we'll see about any gold we got in the pan from those two buckets. Okay, so I've got our stuff panned down to a little bit, you know, maybe less than a quarter cup. And I'm just going to kind of shake it out, fan it out. And there's our nice little gold line in the pan. And so there you go, with three simple to operate, easy pieces of machinery, you can take buckets of material and turn them into gold in no time. Here's our concentrates, and seeing them in the pan and seeing the line of gold in the pan is great, but what we really want is we want a little gold bead that we can end up selling. And so I'm gonna work on getting these smelted down and getting a gold bead. But we've taken our stuff, we're drying it out over our furnace that we're going to use for smelting. We're going to get this all dried up, we're going to mix it with some flux, smelt it, add some collector metal, pour it into our cone mold, and then get our collector metal with our gold in it, and then we're going to cupel it and end up with a gold bead. So we'll get this stuff dried out and move on to the next step. Alright, we got our crucible in there, there's our iron rod. There was 500 grams of material, so I used 500 grams of anhydrous borax, 500 grams of lye, and 250 grams of silica. We'll get that all smelted down and get our collector metal out of there and get it cupelled. And I've got a ton of other videos on smelting showing the process, so you can check those out on our channel. I get that respirator off. And there's our pour. Poured pretty nice. Slag was a little bit thicker than I would have liked. I think there's a little bit of silica in the material, so it may have thickened it up a little bit. But it looks nice and glassy from the stuff that ran over there. And even if I get a little bit running over, all the lead and the gold is so dense that it just goes right down to the bottom of the cone mold. None of it flows out into the slag that runs over the edge. So we're pretty safe there. But we'll let that get cooled down and take a look at our collector metal button at the bottom. All right, there's all our slag from here down. And sitting right on top there is a pretty little lead button. I don't have my gloves on. So there's no mat there to speak of. And there's our lead metal. Man, that separated really nice from the slag. Right now, next step is to take that, put it in a little cupel, and get all that lead out of there. Here's our little lead button. And it's just about as beautiful as can be. It separates awesome from the slag. There's no mat. I weighed it before. I used 54 grams of lead, and I just weighed it again. It weighs 55 and a little bit more, so we recovered all our lead plus a little bit extra. So that's just about as perfect a smelt as you can ask for. And here's a little cupel. The lead is going to oxidize in our electric furnace. The oxides are going to get absorbed by this magnesia cupel. And once the reaction finishes, all the lead will be gone and we'll be left with a little tiny precious metal button in the bottom of this this cupel. And here's our little precious metal bead. We covered that. That's actually a pretty big bead for just those two buckets that were 3/4 full. There's probably only 75 or 80 pounds there. And we got that pretty good sized bead. So let's get it weighed and see what we got. So there you go, 0.99 grams out of our two buckets there. And so you can see how easy it is to run material through the system, smelt it, cupel it, and get some gold.
Okay, so I wanted to talk a little bit about the spare parts for all the machines. We carry all the spare parts in stock, and I wanted to walk you through the different sets. So these are spare dies for the jaw crusher, spare jaw plates, and you have the stationary jaw and the swing jaw here, and they're very easy to replace. It's just a couple bolts to pull them out and replace them. And also, these jaw plates wear pretty much from the bottom half, and so as they wear, you can actually remove them, flip them over, and get a whole new set of life out of them. So they have two wear surfaces you can flip. This is one of our screens for our 16 by 12 hammer mills. And these are laser cut slots here. This particular screen is a 1.2 millimeter slot. And so for typical quartz ore, you get 70% of your material passing a 20 mesh screen when run through this screen here. And then also we have a smaller screen, a 0.8 millimeter. And with that screen, it's typically about 70% passing a 30 mesh screen. This is also one of the hammers we use in both of our 16 by 12 and 24 by 16 hammer mills. This is a high chrome hammer, and the chrome allows for a much harder surface and better wear surface. And in the 16 by 12, we use 20 of these hammers. And in the 24 by 16, we use 24 hammers. So now let's go take a look at our shaker tables. So these are our two different size tables. This is the 4x8, which you saw run the material, and it's a 1 ton per hour table. We also make and sell these 5-foot by 12-foot tables here that are 2 ton per hour tables that we use in our 2 ton per hour turnkey systems. So with the three pieces of equipment that you saw in the video today, really designed for a miner and a budget, there are three distinct advantages. The first is by bulk sampling or small scale processing on site, you get a lot of the information that you need to go for the next step, but you don't have to pay thousands and thousands of dollars on assays to do so. The second one is through your sampling or bulk processing, you actually recover the gold that's produced and you can take that cash and invest it back into the business. And the third one is the equipment is really like building blocks. So you've purchased the three core components of a turnkey system, and if you prove up your site and you want to expand in your milling production, you really just need to buy the equipment to automate the system, so it's hoppers and conveyors. So the last thing I wanted to tease you guys with is we have a smaller system that we're developing that you can actually take the ore from your site, put it in, and get gold out the bottom, but it's all run with gasoline engines. And this consists of a 16 by 12 hammer mill and a sluice that you can put in the back of a pickup truck, literally drive it to your site, and be processing the same day. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know, all of which is in our description below. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.